Hello and welcome back. Today is going to be a huge day. Today is DC Fandom, and we're going to get a whole bunch of looks at new content coming out of the DC world. First up, I'm a little behind. Like, I'm following and trying to re-record stuff. I haven't seen a lot of these. I'd stop watching when like trailers or footage is showing because I want to react to it. So we're kind of just going to jump through this stream that they're doing to see the trailers, the footage, the stuff. So far they've released this first look at Aquaman 2, and then they released a trailer for Peacemaker, which I'm going to watch next. I haven't seen it yet. I watched the Peacemaker panel, but haven't seen it. Later today, we're probably going to get a look at Black Adam, for sure the new trailer for the Batman, which is super exciting. And who knows what else? Maybe Shazam 2, maybe... I don't know what else is coming. I'm excited for a couple surprises. So, but yeah, let's check out this footage from Aquaman 2. Sorry, it's just come through the screen, so.
Aloha, DC fandom. I apologize for the 4-year wait.
Oh my gosh, we've been here since 2017.
But I'm very proud of the sequel because it's tackling a lot of issues environmentally. The stakes are higher, and I'm just excited because I had a big part in my boy James, you know?
I actually really enjoyed the first Aquaman.
Check it out. Like, I'm excited for you to see it.
But I enjoyed it a lot more than the rest of the DC movies.
Like the comic book, the world of Aquaman is so big and so rich.
It's epic. It's huge. It's colorful. The world is at stake.
I'm super excited to be back making the sequel. I have so much invested into it. I love this character. I love what it represents. There's nothing that I've ever been a part of that's like this.
People are going to be in for a treat. When Aquaman 2 comes out, they're going to get a movie that's more mature, but yet still retain its fun to give the audience something different, something new that they haven't seen before.
The success of that movie is
a good horror director, but I really liked
his
visual
sense
here, and I thought
he handled the superhero
stuff
really well. And in this second film, we have turned the dials up to 11. It has the action, the fun, the heart.
Action! Superheroes and supervillains have entertained generations of fans across the globe.
Oh, Batman, you got it? Put that in the movie?
To play around with this cast something? Again is quite a trip. We're having a blast. This movie's a lot of fun.
I think fans are going to be very happy. So I think James is really excited to go all out.
This is an exciting scene. We better get to a little bit of action.
It's going to be a fun adventure. Like it was the first time. Is better.
We see that Black Manta is still
seeking
his vengeance.
I'm just excited to see his performance. I don't love Black Mamba, the
character.
That's
gonna
especially
be something that's
movie.
Exciting
Maybe
for the audience,
time,
something for them
for,
to be swept second. Up into the world of Aquaman again.
Also, my God, that's a name. That's a power.
Kick some ass.
It's a globe-trotting story. We visit so many different worlds. This movie isn't afraid to embrace its fantasy and go on this magical journey.
Yeah,
I think it's going to be really awesome.
It's fun. It's not as dark as some of these seasons. So this is 2022. That's just over a year away. Huh. Okay. Well, cool. So that's our look at Aquaman. I'm going to just get going really quick, cut this, go over to Peacemaker now. I'm so excited for that one, so I want to go see that. So anyways, we'll see you like in a few minutes. There's going to be a lot of stuff today, so try and keep up. DC's doing all their major announcements. Anyways, thanks for watching with me. We'll see you at the next trailer.